Okay, have you ever wondered if your trainer is really telling you the truth, or when a friend is giving you eating tips, are they right? Well, Matt Hoodie is here to break some of the easy health myths.
Yep.
So Matt, let's talk. I mean, this is so important right now because I am going through that stage of hearing so many people give me tips, help me out, especially when it comes to eating.
Definitely.
And that's where a lot of people lose when they're starting to lose weight is in the eating.
Yeah, absolutely. So there's a lot of misinformation out there. Nutrition, right? We all have bodies. We all want to be in the best shape. So there's a lot of stuff out there that just kind of leads us in the wrong direction. So what I try to do is go in, debunk some of those myths, and basically make weight loss a little bit easier for people.
Yeah. All right. Let's get into this because I'm looking at this great dish right
here.
This looks so good. This could be just the perfect meal. Am I right?
Absolutely. Yeah. So that's kind of what people think, right? So one of the biggest myths, one of the biggest things that people always think is that they need to eat a big breakfast. We always hear it's the most important meal of the day, right? Stuff like that. So because of that, they'll go out and they'll do avocado toast and eggs and, you know, turkey bacon or whatever, and they knock back 800 or 1,000 calories in breakfast. And in actuality, breakfast doesn't kickstart your metabolism. What a lot of people don't realize, your metabolism doesn't kind of start and stop within hours. It takes weeks and months at a time. So if you prefer not to eat breakfast, that's perfectly okay. It's okay to skip, which is something, again, you don't hear a lot. Or if you want to do something a little bit smaller for breakfast, if you just feel a little bit better, you can go a little bit lighter and maybe do like a yogurt or something like that.
Well, I heard water. I heard as soon as you get up in the morning,
100%. Yeah, so that one is absolutely true. We do. We want to hit our body. A full bottle of water is great right when we wake up. But we don't need to do like a really large breakfast necessarily. If you prefer it, go for it, but it's not necessarily doing you any favors.
All right, let's go to the next one.
So another one is meal prep, right? So we've all seen this on Instagram and stuff with the Tupperware, people thinking you need to eat six times a day. Again, this kind of goes back to the same thing. So metabolism adjusts over weeks and months at a time, not hours or days. So if you prefer to eat three times a day, six times a day, it's more just about finding what works for you and then working with your own body.
I'm sorry, look in the camera and say that again about what works. Say it, Matt.
Figure out what works for your body.
Thank you. Thank you. Because so many people
That's the number one takeaway is don't fall into a lot of these things that you're seeing on Instagram, on TV, and these things where people are telling you have to do X, Y, and Z. We're all different, and you got to kind of work with what your body already wants to do.
Hold on just a moment. Just here, come here really quick. Michael, did you hear that? Did you hear that? Thank you. He heard it.
It's a lot easier than people think.
Michael constantly just gets on top of me. I'm like, we're two different people.
Yeah, it's a lot. Weight loss can be a lot easier than what people think. And that's kind of my goal. Having been overweight before, it's kind of my goal is to show people it doesn't have to be this thing that takes up your entire life.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Matt, you know what? I think I might need you here. All right. So, all right, let's go to the next thing. Look at you there. That is amazing.
Yeah.
How long did it take you all these people to do these kind of things?
So my transformation took me about 2 years. I lost about 130 pounds. That's kind of what got me into all this. We've worked with a lot of people, 400, 500, 600 pounds. Some transformations take years, others take months. The main thing is we're really just about trying to educate people and make sure they understand how to keep it up on their own.
Okay, let's go a couple more here quickly.
Yeah, so this is a really popular one, especially if you're getting back in the gym right now. A lot of people think you need to slam that protein shake right after your workout. You see the people, as soon as they drop the weights, they're hitting the protein shake. As we've done more and more modern research, we're realizing protein synthesis rates stay elevated for much longer than just 5, 10, 30 minutes afterwards. So again, it goes back to that. Don't create a job out of staying in shape, right? If you prefer to have a protein shake after you work out, that's fine, but understand that those protein synthesis rates are still elevated hours later. So if you want, you can have regular food or you can have your shake then, but it's not necessary to feel like you need to slam a shake right after you finish the workout.
Perfect. All right, let's go down to the snacks.
Then the last one, so eating late at night, right? This is something that we hear about a lot.
Yeah.
There's a lot of misinformation on this one. I actually prefer to have my largest meal late at night. I'll be honest, most of the weight loss clients who I work with are the same way. I always tell people you're more likely to overeat at 9 p.m. than 9 a.m. So I usually try to tell people to leave themselves a little bit more room to have a snack, but just be smart about the snack that you're choosing, right? So it's not the fact that you're eating at 9 p.m., it's the fact that you're eating dark chocolate covered almonds at 9 p.m., right?
Right.
So a lot of people don't realize, like, I brought a little can of, and these are just completely regular, not coated with anything. This little can's 1,000 calories right here.
Wow.
And it would be easy to knock out half of that or a quarter of that in no time at all. I'm a big fan of portion control type things, going to something that once you finish the bag, it's gone, you're done. But you've still gotten some type of little, whether you want something sweet to finish off the night or a little bit of something, but you don't need to necessarily deprive yourself late
so
at night.
You said once the bag's gone, that's it. So you're saying that giant Costco
bag. Don't walk out there. Don't walk out there with a giant Costco bag
of popcorn. Sit all night and finish it?
Exactly. Yeah. It really, at the end of the day, it all comes down to figuring out when your body, based on your schedule, kind of wants to be fed, and then controlling overall calorie intake. It always comes back, especially weight loss. At the end of the day, it always comes back to calories.
Look at that. I'm gonna look good like this guy next week. So, how can they find out more about breaking the health myths?
So you can check me out on matthoodiefitness.com. I've got a lot of information on there. There's a nutritional academy that goes in and kind of educates people about all of these things, but it teaches them how to set it up for themselves. So it's the kind of stuff that once you go through it, you're going to have the tools to be able to set it up for the rest of your life.
Thank you, Matt. There you go. I got some things taken care of, especially Michael, who keeps on, but they're still going to slap my face when I eat the chocolate.
Yeah.